Blackstone presents Twice Royal Lady by Hilary Green. This book is read by Sarah Nichols. The Empress Matilda, Queen of the Germans and Lady of the English. Great by birth, greater by marriage, greatest of all in her offspring. 1. Utrecht, 1110.
I don't want to be married to that man. I don't like him.
She was standing in the antechamber to the great hall of the castle of Utrecht, weighed down by the robes and jewels they had heaped on her. From the other side of the door she could hear the hum of hundreds of voices. There was a rustle of skirts close by, and Sister Agnes knelt to bring her face on the same level.
"Hush, my lady, you must not speak so. King Henry is a great man, the ruler of all the Germans, and soon to be emperor of the Romans, like his ancestor Charlemagne. He does you great honour in asking you to become his wife."
"But I don't like him."
She could feel her lower lip beginning to tremble.
"He's old, and I can't understand what he says."
Sister Agnes had kind eyes, and for a moment her lips curled in a smile.
24 is not old. I know it seems like it when you are only 8, but remember, this is only a betrothal. By the time you are old enough to marry, the difference will not seem so great. And you are a clever girl. You will soon learn to understand German and to speak it. Just think, as King Henry's affianced bride, you will be a queen, and one day, perhaps an empress.
But I don't want...
A hand gripped her shoulder and spun her round so that she was looking up at Reverend Mother Hildegard. Her eyes were not kind.
"You don't want? When will you learn that your petty desires are of no importance? You have a duty. The king, your father, has decreed this match for you, and it is your duty to him, and through him to God, to obey. Must I chastise you again to break this rebellious spirit of yours?"
The door to the hall banged open to admit Lord Roger of Clare, whom the king, her father, had appointed to take charge of her.
"What is going on here? His grace is waiting. Bring the Lady Matilda in at once."
She looked at him, and something opened in her mind, like a door to a lighted room.
"Lord Roger, it would not be fitting for a queen to be whipped, would it? It would be against the dignity of the throne."
She had heard the phrase somewhere, and it seemed to fit. Behind her she heard Mother Hildegard give a sharp tut of disapproval, but Lord Roger bent his head.
"That is so, my lady."
She pressed her lips together to still them and lifted her chin.
"Let us go, then. We must not keep King Henry waiting."
The hall was decked with banners, and the walls were draped with rich tapestries. The heat from hundreds of wax candles blew over her face as she entered, and there were fresh, sweet-smelling rushes beneath her feet. On either side of the central aisle stood hundreds of lords and ladies in brilliantly coloured gowns, who doffed their hats and curtsied as she passed, and whispered to each other. Ahead of her, on a dais, stood the man she must promise to marry, King Henry of Germany, the 5th of that name. It was confusing. She knew one King Henry, her father, Henry of England, the 1st of that name. Not that she had seen very much of him in her short life. Now there was this other Henry, a tall man with heavy dark brows and eyes that did not smile as she came towards him. She was not sure which of them frightened her more. Her little procession reached the dais, and the king stepped down to meet her. But instead of speaking to her, he looked across her head at Lord Roger and asked, in his heavily accented French,
"Have you brought the promised dowry?"
Lord Roger bowed.
"I have, Your Grace."
He snapped his fingers, and 4 pages came forward, carrying between them 2 heavy chests bound with iron. They set them down and opened the lids. The chests were full of silver coins. 10,000 marks, she had heard someone say.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.